President Obama telling NBC News that he deserves a second term. The president saying that his administration has made progress on improving the economy, but more work needs to be done. Do voters agree with that? Pollster Frank Luntz put that question to them. He's here with me. Good morning to you, Frank.
Good morning.
Three clips here I want to play. The first question, describe how President Obama is doing. Roll this.
I want you to give me a word or phrase to describe Barack Obama.
Confused.
Inept.
He's a socialist.
Honest. A weak leader.
Steady hand on the wheel.
Socialist.
Ineffective.
Insufficient.
Very extreme. They either love him or they hate him. The challenge for Barack Obama is that the American people, 80% have made up their minds. 40% are voting for him for re-election, guaranteed. 40% are voting against him, guaranteed. And the battle is for that 20%.
I see. So the whole hope and change thing is still out there, but you have to figure out whether or not you have enough time to change things. But then you asked why they feel this way. Roll this.
He talked a good game. He suckered me in.
You voted for him.
I did vote for him, yes. I was excited about the change and hopeful that our country would be very different. And now, 3 years later, here we are, and I just feel lost and confused, much like I think he is.
I don't think that he's completely terrible. I mean, anybody who was going to get that position, you know, the economy was just horrible. And I really think that he's trying, especially in...
It's the same old argument. He inherited a problem. He made a lot of promises.
He did,
but I'm sick of hearing it.
I'm sick of hearing it. You've got, everyone says that the problem already existed before Obama took over. The question is, did he make it worse or has he made it better? And you hear that, I'm sick of hearing it. The divisions are so deep and so strong and so intense and so passionate that every time I go out and talk to Americans, and by the way, in that focus group, there are more Obama voters than there were McCain voters, but some of those Obama people are having second thoughts.
How many in that group?
27 people, 27? 15 Obama voters, 12 McCain voters.
I see, okay. And then you ask whether or not they believe he's a uniter or a divider, which is an interesting question. Roll this.
Is this election going to bring us together, or is this election going to pull us apart?
It's going to get real.
By show of hands, how many of you say it's going to pull us apart? Well, you know what? God help us. It's going to be a very divisive campaign. It's going to be a very angry campaign. And if our 27 voters are any indication, things are going to get worse before they get better.
I have to give Fox News credit that it put someone of that weight and girth on national television. It is very depressing. If you believe in civility, decency, and respect, if you believe that voters should be able to talk to each other and disagree without being disagreeable, and to have an exchange like you and I are having, what I'm hearing out there, it's not going to happen. The negative ads, the attacks on each other, and voter frustration is so great that I think we're going to come apart by November.
You said what the challenge is for Obama. What is the challenge for Republicans?
They have to prove that it's not just about Obama's failures, or they'll end up like John Kerry. They'll come close, but not close enough. You don't just vote against the president. You have to vote for the alternative, and they haven't succeeded in that. Second is they have to show that they won't do just as good. They have to show that they'll do better on the economy. And third, it is about quality of life, not just standard of living. Will my kids have a better quality of life than me? If they can show that path, they're going to be competitive. But right now, Obama's the front runner.
I see. And you conclude that based on the folks you talk to, the reaction is mixed.
The reaction is mixed.
And it's a coin flip right now as to what happens.
But if it were 51-49, I would say Obama has the advantage at this point going into the election.
Interesting stuff. Frank, thanks for sharing with us, okay? Frank Luntz here.